Hello, Dr. Berg here. Listen, I got this question recently. I have no more gallbladder. Can I eat what I want now, right? Because obviously the problem is solved. So let's talk about that. So what happens, you have the liver that makes bile that travels down a tube, the bile duct, and it's supposed to go into the gallbladder that it gets stored and concentrated because you need a majorly concentrated, significant amount of bile to be able to digest a certain meal. So right now, which just trickles down the bile duct in very small amounts into the small intestine without being concentrated or stored, okay? So basically there's 700,000 gallbladder surgeries a year. And the problem is when they take them out, they don't really correct the real problem. You see, the gallstones are a symptom of something deeper. Sluggish gallbladder is not the problem. It's a symptom of usually either high estrogen or more commonly high insulin. Not necessarily because you're diabetic, or it's more of a pre-diabetes. It's called insulin resistance. And insulin resistance is a very common thing. Here are the symptoms. You're not satisfied after you eat. You need a little something sweet. You get tired after you eat. You get bloated after you eat. You can't go for a long period of time without eating, or you get severe hungry or blood sugar issues. You have cravings for sweets. You use the bathroom at night too frequently when you're trying to sleep. There's a lot of symptoms. But anyway, if this was causing the gallstones or the gallbladder problem, and you remove the gallbladder, the problem is still there. Okay, so you remove the symptoms, kind of taking the little red indicator light off of your dashboard, and you keep driving. Eventually you may run into a problem if you don't change what caused it originally. So I put some links down below. If this is your situation, you should probably, I don't know, at least study up on it to see if you have this and what to do about it so you don't end up with more problems. Because if you don't correct it, you can end up with a lot of other issues that are related to insulin. Now, the other point is that without enough bile, there is a chance that you could actually have long-term deficiencies of vitamin A. So the vision starts going, hard to see at night, night blindness, things like that. Skin, psoriasis, sinus, that's vitamin A, lung tissue. Vitamin D, bone, mood. You start getting achy muscle and joint pain and even bone pain. Calcium issues. Vitamin E, that's heart, that's repair, wound healing, hormones, skin, oxygen carrying capacity. So when you're deficient in vitamin E, you might find that when you go up a flight of stairs, you're out of breath easily. Vitamin K, you get bruising, unnecessarily bruising. You didn't injure yourself, but you start getting bruising. Like, where did that come from? And all the membranes on your cells are made from these fats. So again, if you can't absorb these because you're not enough bile, you may also want to take some bile salts. Not a lot, just a little bit after the meal. Okay? So this is just some key points if this is your situation. So thanks for watching. Put your comments down below. Hey, you probably already subscribed, but if you haven't, press this little button down below and I will keep you updated.